Our Easter production is about to begin. Today you are going to see aspects of Jesus' ministry brought to life and get a peek into what it may have looked like while Jesus walked the earth. During this performance, there will be loud noises, large set pieces moving throughout the aisles, and a complete blackout. It is very important that you please stay seated throughout the duration of the performance for your safety and your children's safety. And now, prepare your hearts as we bring you Easter at the Rock.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. Then God said, "Let us make man in our own image, in our likeness." So God created man in his own image. God saw all that he had created, and it was good. There was a time when God walked the face of the earth with man, man living in perfect harmony with God. But then sin came into the world through man and brought death with it. Just as the word says, "For all have sinned and fallen short of God's glory." So death spread to everyone. There was no way to escape death. Sin is the barrier that kept us from God. And in the separation, only one thing could redeem us. Name is
I know him. I've seen him. Sometimes those who are unnoticed see it all. When you tend gardens, you see a lot of things. And a simple gardener like me has seen a great deal. This Jesus was a humble man who washed the feet of his followers. He seemed like an average man at first glance, but nothing about this man was average. Everywhere he went, miracles followed him. The blind could see, the deaf could hear. Men born crippled stood and walked, and the dead were raised. His teachings were backwards, and his kingdom upside down. He was so different from other men and other teachers. Even as a young child, it was obvious he was special. There was a time when his parents were frantic, looking everywhere for him, telling everyone that he was lost. But oh no, 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 he was not lost. This young boy of 12 was in the temple praising God for 3 days. That is still my favorite story. And I remember the first time I saw him extend mercy. It moved me. There was a woman.
The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, in which a man took and planted in his field. And though the mustard seed is the smallest of all seeds, yet it grows when we go forth.
You have brought shame to your husband! Jesus!
Wait!
Let us take him, her, to the teacher and see what he has to say.
Please, please, you're hurting me.
I don't care.
Let me go.
Quiet, you. You have made your choice. Was your sin worth all of this?
What? Where is he? What about his sin?
Silence!
How come I was dragged out here to die, and he was left behind?
How dare you speak to us in this manner? You will pay for your sins, woman. And he is no concern of yours. You will regret that, woman. Teacher, this woman, she was caught in the act of adultery. Adultery, teacher. Now you know the law of Moses just as I do. The law commands that a woman such as this must be stoned to death. Now what have you to say? Adultery. What is this? This is no time for compassion. What is this? Adultery. What is this? What is he writing? What? How do you know this? No. Teacher, she must be stoned. This woman must be stoned. She was caught in the act of adultery. She must be stoned.
He who is without sin can throw the first stone.
Without sin? What does he mean? Are the Pharisees?
Nathaniel?
Nathaniel?
Malchus.
Yes, Malchus, yes.
How about you?
It must be the high priest. I don't know. Is he the
Let us depart.
Then what? Jesus saved her. Then what? I don't know.
Woman, where are they who accuse you?
I don't know.
I don't understand.
And neither do I accuse you. Now go and leave your life of sin.
I don't understand. I deserve to die.
Woman, you are free.
Free?
Free. Now go and sin no more.
Thank you. Thank you.
I have never seen a teacher with such wisdom and authority, one who forgives and does not condemn. I thought to myself, who is this man? News of Jesus spread like wildfire, and everyone wanted to see him. Some just wanted to touch his cloak, and still others were more desperate. I remember one afternoon, I was walking in the garden near one of the disciples' houses, and this group of men were willing to do whatever it took to get their friend to Jesus. And Jesus always welcomed interruptions like this. What a day it was.
All right, I know it might smell a little fishy. Come on, what is she?
We all know where that smell is coming from.
Yeah.
What are you all looking at me?
We're fishermen.
All right, but remember, it's that fishy smell that puts food in all your mouth.
Yes, it does. But would it kill you to wash your clothes in the sea every once in a while?
Oh, once a month. I'd rather have this smell than the taste of your cooking, cousin. Oh, that's a surprise. Besides, I don't smell anything.
All right, settle down. Let's get started.
Okay. Fishermen.
It's true.
Some more of those fish stories. No one can serve two masters.
That's true.
Therefore, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or what you will drink, or what you will wear. Is the body not more important than clothing, and life not more important than food? Take the birds of the air. They do not store away in barns, but yet your heavenly Father still feeds them.
Are you not more valuable? Teacher, what's coming down?
My son, your sins are forgiven.
Can he forgive sins?
What does he mean?
Can he forgive sins?
Yeah, he does.
Why do you entertain evil thoughts in your minds? What is easier for me to say, your sins are forgiven, or to get up and walk? But so that you may know that I have the authority to forgive sin.
You have no authority.
Yes. He forgives.
My friend, get up, pick up your mat, and walk.
What a man he was. These healings and forgiveness showed grace and mercy and love. This man, Jesus, was not just a teacher, not just a prophet, but he was the promised Messiah. And many, just like myself, believed in him. But there were others who did not feel as we did. The religious leaders tried to prove him wrong every chance they got, but he knew how to answer all their questions. And this upset them greatly. And when he declared himself to be the Son of God, they began to plot to kill him. As the crowds were growing, so did their hatred for him. And when they saw the opportunity, 30 pieces of silver was all it took for Judas, one of Jesus' own disciples, to betray him.
Jesus, all the followers have bedded down for the night. Master, is everything all right?
What's wrong? Did I ever tell you that time when I was a boy? I went to the temple without telling my parents. I ended up staying for 3 days. Oh, my mother was so worried when she finally found me. But later that night, she gave me this bottle of myrrh. And she told me a king gave it to me on the day I was born. And every year, to remember my birth, she would anoint me with it. After all these years, I still have some left. Peter, James, John, I love you. You have always been there for me. But I fear tonight will be hardest for you to stay by my side.
But Lord, I'll always be there. Yes, always.
Lord. Always, Lord.
My heart is burdened. You must leave me so I can pray. I am overwhelmed.
Master, let us help.
Yes, Lord, let's
help. We don't want to leave you alone.
No.
Peter, I won't be alone. Now go and pray and be strong. Father, save me from this trap set before me. Abba, save me. Abba, you can do all things. Father, let this cup pass. Father! Father! Let this cup pass. Abba, not my will. Abba! Not my will, but yours be done.
Anything.
Peter.
Judas, do you see him?
Peter! Could you not stay awake and pray?
Where is this man?
Get up! Get up!
Forgive me,
pray! so that you do not fall into temptation. Pray!
There he is.
Peter, look.
That's him.
The hour is at hand.
Malachus.
Someone's coming.
Where the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners.
Look. It's Judas.
What is he doing with the Pharisees?
I don't know.
Supper early.
I don't know.
Judas.
I don't understand.
Do what you've come to do. Rabbi.
Judas. Yes. Traitor.
Take him.
Traitor.
No, Peter.
No.
Peter.
No.
They're taking no. Peter,
no.
They're taking
no.
him!
No!
Peter! Peter! Enough! Stop! Stop! Peter! He who lives by the sword dies by the sword. Put it down. Put it down. Am I leading a rebellion that you come at me with chains and swords? I was at the temple every day, and you didn't lay a hand on me. But the hour of darkness has come.
Take him.
No, no, Jesus. No.
No.
No. No.
We have to go.
No.
We have to go.
No. Jesus. No. 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 No.
Three lashes.
No.
No. Come on. Get him. This man calls himself the Messiah. Messiah. Sacrilege.
Find leather for the king.
Let's give him some lashes. Again. Again. Again! Harder! They call you King of Kings. Where is your crown, King? Here it is. Your Majesty! Strike him again! 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 Enough! For now.
Just like that, he was taken right before my eyes. They took him so they could torture him. He was whipped beyond recognition. They fashioned a crown of thorns and they pierced it to his skull. They beat him, mocked him, spit at him,
It tried him, convicted him, and finally, they crucified him.
Redeemed, only beauty remains. My orphan heart was given a name. My morning grew quiet, my feet rose to dance. When death was arrested,
he was despised and rejected by men. A man of sorrows and acquainted with grief.
Our Savior displayed on a criminal's cross. Darkness rejoiced as though heaven had lost.
But just as sin entered the world through one man, sin was conquered through one man. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save it. And just like Jesus said, 3 days later!
But then Jesus arose with our freedom in hand. That's when death was arrested.
So free, washes over.
we just thank the Lord today that we are forgiven, that we are free. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. At this time, I'm going to ask everybody to just have a seat right where you're at. No one get up, no one leave during this time. It's vitally important for your eternal life that you stay put and you listen to what God is speaking to you right now. Just before your eyes, you saw the God.